Today we're going to automate a bi-weekly timesheet in Excel using special formulas to auto-populate the dates and create a drop-down list selection for the PTO type. We'll also see how to calculate total hours, overtime, and pay. Be sure and check out my other video on how to create this template from scratch, and then I also have two other videos on how to automate a semi-monthly and a weekly timesheet. If you want to get a jump start on your project, you can purchase and download these templates. I'll include a link in the description below this video. I hope you like it. Let's take a look. So here's our bi-weekly timesheet template. And notice up here in the pay period start date area, if I enter a start date, I'm going to enter a different date, say 7/21/24, and hit enter. Notice that the pay period end date automatically populates, as well as all of the days and dates over here on the timesheet. So again, if I change that date, let's say our biweekly pay period starts on a Monday instead of a Sunday, let's put 7/22/24 and hit enter. And notice that these days and dates will automatically populate. So the formulas that we use to create this, notice that what we can do is set up the pay period start date as an entry cell for users to enter that date. So we have helper text set up to let users know to enter that date. And then we have the pay period end date automatically calculating. And that's because we have a formula up in that cell. We say equals G3. Cell G3 that contains the pay period start date plus 13, because Excel handles dates as numbers. So we can add the number of days to include the current date, and that gives us a 14-day pay period. So we can put any date in here as our pay period start date, and then this date will calculate to be the 14th day out from that date. So it'll capture your 14-day or biweekly pay period, the start and end dates. So down here in our table for the timesheet, what we can do is for the first date in the row, we can select that cell and say equals G3, right? Because we want to have the first day of that pay period be the pay period start date. So those dates are going to be equal. Then the next formula down, we're going to say C10, so this date that's in the cell above, plus 1 will be the next day. And then what we do is we can take our mouse to the right corner where it turns into crosshairs, and this means we can copy this formula down, and it will automatically place that formula into each cell correctly. So it will add 1 to the cell above it. So notice C13 plus 1, C14 plus 1, and so forth. So that will automatically populate all the correct dates down here on your timesheet for the biweekly pay period. So in order to get the days to update correctly based on the date that's in this column, we use a different formula. So I'm going to click there. Notice the formula that we use, and I'll include this in the description below the video. It's equals text parentheses. Then you select the cell that you want to have the day of the week referenced, which is the date that's in cell C10 in this case. And then we say comma, space, quotes, DDD for the day, end quotes, and close those parentheses. Once you have that formula in there for the first one, you can also copy that all the way down the rows, and it will copy that formula down. So notice this cell is going to look at the date that's in cell C11, and it's going to put the day of the week. So that's how we set that up to automatically populate. So all of these dates in these cells, days and dates, are going to automatically populate just based on entering the pay period start date up here. Now, what we want to also do is make sure that these cells are formatted as a date. Otherwise, they might show up as a number. So you can right-click, click on Format Cells, and make sure that date is selected, and then click OK. Same thing over here. You're going to want all of the cells in column C to be formatted as a date. And then you can format the cells over here in column B as general, because they're going to show up with the day of the week as text. Over here in the rest of your timesheet, you can select everything where people are going to be inputting hours, and you can right-click and format those cells as a number to 2 decimal places, and then click OK. And then to set up the drop-down list selection, we're going to set up a drop-down list so users can select what type of PTO that they may want to enter on their timesheet. And to do that, we add an additional tab to the workbook, and we can create our drop-down list selection here. So in this case, I typed vacation, sick, volunteer, jury, and leave as different types of paid time off that someone could select from. And so then over here, what we do is we can select the first cell where we want to input that drop-down list, come up to your data tab, over on data tools, drop down the data validation drop-down, and select data validation. Up here under allow, you're going to select a list, and then you'll have your cursor here in the source area, and you can actually jump to the tab where you have your list typed out and select all of the drop-down list items. And then you can go to your input message tab up here. If you want to have an input message, you can type that out here. It's optional. You don't have to use one. Same thing with an error alert. You don't have to set that up, but if someone did enter the wrong value in there, you could have an error message that would pop up. And then when you're done programming that data validation, just click OK. And then you have a drop-down list where users, when they click on that cell to go and enter a value, they'll have a little drop-down that will prompt them with that helper text that says select PTO, and they can drop down and select whatever type of PTO that they need to input there. And then once you set up that data validation in the first cell there, all you have to do is copy that by hitting Control C, and then you can select the rest of the rows in that column and hit enter to paste, and then the data validation table will show up in every cell there for you. So now we want to set up our calculations for total hours. So I'm going to select the cell here for total hours, and notice that I have the sum formula equals sum, and then I have the range of cells from D through E that are going to calculate the sum of those total hours over here. And once I enter that, of course, I can just simply copy that formula all the way down, and it will include the sum of each row of hours on the timesheet. So you'll have a column there for total hours for each day that you can reference. Then down here at the bottom section, we have an area where we can calculate the rest of our information that we're going to need for our timesheet. So this will calculate total hours. This is a timesheet where employees are entering whole hours, not time in and time out. So it will add up all of the regular hours that they've worked and recorded during this pay period. So to do that, you're just going to simply set up a sum formula and select all of the cells in that column, and it will sum those together. Then you can drag that formula over to the other two cells, and it will set up and sum both the overtime and any PTO or time off hours that they've recorded on their timesheet. Over here, you can simply do a sum of all of the total hours, and that's what we have over here in this cell here. Now, the next input cell for your users, or for anyone who's setting up this spreadsheet for use, will be the rate per hour, somebody's base rate of pay. And so once that's entered in, we have a cell that will automatically calculate the overtime rate of pay, which is the base rate of pay times 1.5%. So if that is different at your organization for any reason, you can update the formula that there. You would simply say equals this cell, which is your base rate of pay, times whatever factor that you pay for your overtime rate. And then if this paid time off is paid at the same rate as your base pay rate, then you can simply say equals D25, which is the base rate of pay. Then down below, we can calculate total pay. And then these formulas, we're simply multiplying the total hours times the rate per hour. And that gives us a total there. Over here in this column, we are going to multiply the overtime hours times the overtime rate, and it gives us a total. And then we're going to multiply the total paid time off hours times their base rate of pay, and that will give us a total there. And then in the totals, we can simply sum all of these totals here below. And so we say equals sum, and then we selected the range of D26 to F26. Now, once you're done setting up your timesheet, you can actually hide the PTO type tab where you set up your drop-down list selection. You can click on that tab, right-click, and hide that tab. and then jump back. You can even, if you wanted to, you could duplicate the biweekly tab 26 times and create an entire workbook with all of your pay period start dates set out for the whole year. And you would do that by right-clicking on your tab, saying move or copy, move to end, create a copy, click OK. And then you'd have another biweekly tab where you could go and update the date for the next week's pay period and save it that way. Be sure and check out my other videos. I'm going to show you how to automate a semi-monthly timesheet. And in this one, we'll do some neat tricks with conditional formatting that will hide any days from the timesheet that don't fit in the pay period. And then we'll also do a weekly timesheet where we'll automate the time in and time out and calculate to account for any breaks. And then we'll also calculate for overtime for hours worked over 40 in a work week. Be sure and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. And if you liked it, be sure and share this video with all your friends and colleagues. You can visit my website, SharonSmithHR.com. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.